Okay, we have two more videos left dealing with this substitution technique for solving integrals of this form. We have this problem here, and then in the remaining video, we have a more challenging problem. But let's see how we can apply this technique. Here we have the integral of dx divided by 2 plus x, and we're integrating where x goes from 0 to pi over 2. So, if we're going to use the substitution technique, the cosine of x is going to be this, and the dx is going to be this. The denominator has 2 plus the cosine of x. So, let's look here and see. Let's deal with the denominator first. We have 2 plus the cosine of x, which is this, 1 minus z squared divided by 1 plus z squared. And let's see. Adding these together, we'll have 2 plus 2z squared. Plus 1 minus z squared. And this is going to be divided by 1 plus z squared. And let's see, it looks like here we have 2z squared minus z squared. 2 plus 1 is 3, so we have z squared plus 3. And that's our denominator term. So let's rewrite the integral. This is in the denominator, so we have to multiply by its reciprocal. And now we're expressing this integral now in terms of z. So right now we're going to note x has to go from 0 to pi over 2. And here we're going to have 1 plus z squared divided by 3 plus z squared times dx 2 dz divided by 1 plus z squared. These will cancel. And this will be equal to 2 integral of dz divided by 3 plus z squared. We've seen this several times around now when we're dealing with this kind of substitution technique, getting integrals of this form. Let z be equal to the square root of 3 times the tangent of theta. So 3 plus z squared would be 3 plus 3 tangent squared of theta, or this will be 3 times the secant squared of theta. And dz will equal the square root of 3 times the secant squared of theta d theta. So we have to do another trig substitution here. But it's a very simple one, obviously. So this integral here equals 2, the integral of dz, which is the square root of 3, times the secant squared of theta divided by 3 times the secant squared of theta. This is secant squared of theta d theta up here. So it looks like this is going to be 2 divided by the square root of 3. These cancel. The integral d theta is just theta. Now we have to backtrack. We go back to first this substitution. The tangent of theta will equal z divided by the square root of 3. So theta will equal the inverse tangent of z divided by the square root of 3. So we have from here, we have 2 over the square root of 3 times theta. And theta is the inverse tangent of z. But z itself was a substitute. Z is the tangent of x over 2. So we're going to have 1 over the square root of 3, the tangent of x over 2. And there are limits on x. X has to go from 0 to pi over 2. So this integral here, integral from 0 to pi over 2 of dx divided by 2 plus the cosine of x will equal 2 divided by the square root of 3, the inverse tangent of this expression, 1 over the square root of 3 times the tangent of x over 2, where x goes from 0 to pi over 2. Okay, let's put our values in for x, and this will equal 2 divided by the square root of 3 times the inverse tangent of 1 over the square root of 3 times the tangent of, now x is pi over 2. Pi over 2 divided by 2 is pi over 4, minus 2 divided by the square root of 3, inverse tangent of 1 over the square root of 3. And here we're going to have the tangent of 0. Okay, so let's see, here we have the tangent of pi over 4, that's the tangent of 45 degrees, that's 1, so this will be equal to 2 over the square root of 3 times the inverse tangent of 1 over the square root of 3, minus 2 over the square root of 3. The tangent of 0 is 0. So here we have times the inverse tangent of 0. And that is 0. So now what is the inverse tangent of 1 over the square root of 3? The only angles that have square roots of 3 of them are either 60 degrees or 30 degrees. Let's see, the sine of 30 degrees, pi over 6, that is 1/2. And the cosine of pi over 6, that is the square root of 3 over 2. So the tangent of 30 degrees, or pi over 6, that will equal this divided by this, 1/2 times 2 over that. So it looks like the inverse tangent of this is going to be pi over 6. The inverse tangent of pi over 6 will give us 1 over the square root of 3, which is what this is. So finally we have 2 pi divided by square root of 3 times 6. Well, that would be pi over 3 times the square root of 3. So we're saying this here is equal to pi over 3 times the square root of 3. And that then would be the solution to this integral here. Okay, using this substitution right here to get us to this point was really pretty straightforward. I'll come back in our final integral, our final video, we're going to use the substitution technique in a problem that's going to be a little bit more challenging. So come back and join us for that one, and we'll see what we can make of it.